Hey everybody. I have a new pen. It's a TWSBI ECO. Now, I've never owned a pen made by TWSBI. TWSBI pens have only been around for a few years now. But the parent company, Tashin Precision in Taiwan, has a long history of making high-end pens for other companies, for other brands. And somewhere around 2009, they decided they would start making their own pen with their own name. So Tashin Precision spun off a company that they named TWSBI. Let's see what we have in the box. Here's the pen. Here is some silicone grease. And here is a wrench. And here's a breakdown of the parts of the pen. TWSBI made this pen so that the user can disassemble it and maintain it. Now this pen is different than a lot of the pens that you see on my channel. A lot of the pens that you see on my channel use an ink converter or an ink cartridge. But this pen is a piston filling pen. and it holds the ink inside the barrel. And because the barrel is larger in diameter than an ink cartridge or an ink converter, it's going to hold more ink. Now, this is a medium nib, but I think you can also get this pen in a extra fine, a fine, a medium, a bold, and a 1.1 millimeter stub. It's not a bad looking pen. What do you say we ink it up? Now, right offhand, you might think that I would put black ink in this. But I'm going to use Noodler's Apache. Now, I don't have to shake this bottle, but I kind of like the sound that it makes when I do. Well, this is kind of a dark reddish orange ink. Whenever you ink a fountain pen, you want to have something to blot the ink from the pen once you've filled it. So we'll dip the pen up to about here, and we'll go down with the piston, expelling any air out of the barrel, and then we'll go back up and that drew ink into the barrel. See if I can get a little bit more into it. Let me go down again and back up. Here's where the blotter comes in handy. Now, before I do anything else, I'm going to put the cap back on the ink. Never leave a bottle of ink sitting around without a cap. Never, ever. Never, ever. If you do, it could ruin your day when it tips over. One word about the silicone grease. They give this to you so that you can take apart the pen and maintain the pen. You can clean the pen, you can, I believe you rub the silicone grease around the piston. Maybe the screw, I don't know. I've never had one of these TWSBI pens. I was always concerned about the quality because I'd heard so many different things about the quality of the pens. These are just instructions. The first models of the TWSBIs were the 530 and then I think the 540 and the 580, and I knew there were quality problems with those. Boy, that post really nice. It fits really well. This may be the best posting fountain pen I've ever handled. It's gonna dry. I see some debris on the feed. I'll zoom in on that. I don't know if you can see it. I'm not even sure what it is. I want to be careful that I don't damage the feed as I try to remove whatever this is. It's the same color as the ink, so I imagine it came out of the ink bottle. See if we can get this thing to write. Let's help it just a little bit by making the piston go down just a little. Now, I told you this was a medium nearby. Was mistaken. Yeah, it's the 1.1 millimeter stub tip. Still rather dry. I'm going to turn the page and start with a fresh page, and then we'll write a list. Let's make a list. I'll zoom in a little bit. This pen that it writes, at least at this moment, is writing very dry. Maybe it will improve as we go. I find myself having to push down a little bit more with this pen than with others. Have you figured out what it is I'm writing? Let's read the list. Take it easy. Witchy woman. Lion eyes. Already gone. Desperado. One of these nights. Tequila sunrise. Take it to the limit. Peaceful, easy feeling. And best of my love. Yeah, these are songs from the Eagles. It's from their greatest hits CD. But back to this pen. I'm not sure what to think about it. It's getting better, I suppose. I do wish I had chosen to use black ink instead of this Apache. The quality issue of a TWSBI. There were some, but the company redesigned the models that had problems, is the way I understand it. And when they had problems with their nib, my understanding is they changed companies. They chose a different supplier of the nibs. So they are and have tried really hard to rectify any quality issues. But part of the problem might be because they tout this pen as a pen that can be taken apart by the consumer, and they even give you a wrench to do it with. So maybe some of the quality issues are because the consumer accidentally breaks the pen while they try to work on it. The pen is, it's not a bad looking pen. Clayton TWSBI made this pen to do battle, so to speak, with these two pens here, the Lamy Safari and the Pilot Metropolitan. This TWSBI ECO is about a $30 pen. And the Lamy Safari is about mid-20s, I think. But if you purchase the ink converter to go with it, that's another $5. So that puts you right close to $30. And the Pilot Metropolitan cost half of what these two do. This is a $15 pen. So these are all entry-level fountain pens. And this pen, this Pilot Metropolitan, is a nice little pen. Now, I have damaged the nib on mine. I dropped it and it bent, and it really messed it up. Maybe I can show you that. But before I dropped it, this thing wrote like butter. It was so smooth. I have another one of these. It's brand new. It's still in a box. I'm going to be giving that one away. And I purchased this pen just so I can give it away. But because it writes so dry, I'm not sure if I should give it away. Maybe I shouldn't have gotten the stub nib. It does feel like it's getting better, though. Or maybe not. So I'm not sure what the deal is, if it's the ink or the nib. I know TWSBI has a really good customer service department. They really take their reputation seriously. And they're always trying to improve upon any problems And like I mentioned before, they even have redesigned certain models to make them better. And their price is definitely competitive. But the dryness, it's like there's not enough ink getting to the tip of the nib. So does anybody have any recommendations? All of you pen gurus? Something other than buy a more expensive pen? I do like the looks of this pen. Maybe I'll flush out this ink and put in some black ink. I could do that. And we'll just put this ink back into the bottle. Give me a few minutes and I'll be back with some black ink. Okay, I'm back and I have black ink in the pen. What a difference. Let's write another list. Oops, should have been a G. Misread the list. Everything she wants. Heartbeat like a baby. If you were there. Credit card baby. Careless whisper. Freedom. Wake me up before you go-go. So many of you may have guessed that those are song titles from this CD. Now the pen is writing totally different with this Noodler's black ink. But you know what? I'm still not impressed. Maybe it's just me. Maybe the pen's okay. Maybe it's not a bad pen. But maybe these are just so much better. Well, anyhow, I'm tired of messing with this pen. Maybe I'll polish the nib a little bit. Maybe. Anyhow, that's enough for tonight. I'm getting mighty tired. Thanks for watching.